Sup with y'all, JBZ. We back at it. Today, I'm going to be giving my first impressions and a bit of a review of the Outriders demo. Let me start by saying this. This demo's free. If you really want to get a feel of the game, go play it yourself. But if you want to stick around and hear what I got to say, then that's cool too. Smile. I'd like to say I've put a solid amount of hours into this game so far. About 15 or so, damn near. Maybe 20. I gotta check Steam or something. I don't know. We gonna see. But I've played my fair bit of looter shooters. A shit ton of Destiny 2. A whole hell of a lot of Borderlands 2. A little bit of Borderlands 3 too. And Division as well. So I'm pretty sure I know what I'm looking for in terms of a good looter shooter. First, I want to talk about the story. Don't worry, I won't be spoiling anything for y'all. If you want hella details and you want to experience this shit yourself, then I will not be spoiling it. Or go play the demo if you want to go do all that. But basically, the general synopsis of the story is humans destroy Earth, so humanity's looking for a new planet to live on. That's all I'll go into. That's like the basic breakdown of what the story is about, I guess, or how it starts at least. Just that alone, I can say for myself, intrigued me to know more of what's going on in the world and how we got to that point. But based on the demo that we got, I'm not sure that we'll be going into that in the main quest, at least. Now, the side quest very well could lean more onto the lore, but speaking of the side quests, there's four that were able to play during the Outriders demo, and they were nothing crazy. You know, a couple of find this thing over here and kill that guy type of missions. Nothing too crazy, but they were serviceable. One did unlock a vendor, so if there's more like hub areas in this game, I'm not sure if there is or not, but if there's more hub areas in this game, I'm sure we're gonna get more quests that unlock more vendors and whatnot in the social spaces or whatever. Now, let's talk about the gameplay and customization. The gameplay in this game, at first, I wasn't really sure how much I would like it off first glance and off the videos that I saw, but I can say it is very fun with all the abilities you can use. And I've only used one of the four classes so far. There's also a loot system, very similar to Destiny 2 or Borderlands, you know, Division, all those other games, with white drops being common, green being uncommon, blue being rare. I haven't seen any purple drops. I'm sure there'll be in there when the full game releases. There's also, you know, gold being legendary. In this demo, your progress will be saved towards the real game, which is unheard of. I've never seen a demo do that. And let me know if y'all have, but I haven't. With that being said, there's people like me that discovered that and are like, damn, we're gonna play a shit ton of this demo, and have also come to realize that legendary guns are dropping now in the demo. The farming process is, from what I could tell so far, the farming process is very similar to Borderlands farming. Like, you know, you quit, save, and then go kill the boss over and over again. With that, but in this game, it's without the quitting. Just kind of do a quest over and over again, or you let enemies kill you before, so you can get restart to a checkpoint. So if you're not really into killing the same boss over and over again, I'm not sure you're gonna want to be doing this right now. I mean, you don't have to. There's no reason really to. But also, I'll be posting another video on how I got my two legendaries that I've gotten so far on the channel soon. So stay tuned for that. I don't think that's gonna be the final way that they're gonna have us getting legendaries in this game. I say this because there are world tiers in the game, which basically up the difficulty of the enemies while also giving you a higher drop rate for legendary weapons. Maybe armor as well, not 100% sure just yet. And also there will be end game activities after completing story shit, you know what I mean? Been comparing them to maybe dungeons in Destiny 2 or raids, I'm not 100% sure. And it's a 3-man activity that's gonna be supposed to be the end game activities. So compare them to raids or dungeons in Destiny. From my understanding, there's about 10 of these dungeons you can run that you can run to get your world tier up. And they also come with innate higher drop chances for legendaries as well. So I assume that we'd have to be farming these dungeon type end game activities to get lots and lots of legendaries. So that's why I believe they'll have us run these activities to get legendary gear. So that's a plus, I'd say, if these activities are as fun as they seem. Another plus that I can tell with this game so far is it's not gonna have the problem that Destiny 2 has with trying to balance exotics or legendaries around PvP as well as PvE, so they can kind of just go crazy with what the legendaries do. And from what I can tell from the legendaries that I've gotten so far, it seems pretty promising. The customization in this game doesn't seem too wild from a fashion standpoint, but maybe that will change with more armor, but I'm not 100% sure just yet. The customization from like a build standpoint, as in like how effective your character is and where your skill points go, it seems very promising, and there just seems to be a lot of potential. There are mods that spawn on your weapon, blue rarity or higher, also your armor, that can give you, can vary from different types of mods, such as lifesteal or increasing your ability size or the timer or how long it lasts. I also believe I saw in one of their promotion videos that there's thousands, or maybe hundreds, I can't remember exactly, don't quote me on it. There's like thousands or hundreds of different types of mods in this game. So if the customization is that deep and it really switches up how you play the game, then I can't help but say, but that's just a win. That's so much more replayability right then and there in that quote. So if it's anything like that, then that's a win. But in conclusion, I'd say this game has an immense amount of potential. I think it's worth pre-ordering. I've already done it. So, you know, I'm already in it. If I waste my money, I waste my money. But hopefully I don't. You know, I think this game has a shit ton of potential. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. And I can't wait to play more. But, well, that's the end of the video. Make sure y'all rate, comment, subscribe. Share with your friends if you want more. And follow me on Twitch and Twitter in the description below. Bye, guys.